Hey everybody, Marcos Villegas here with Joseph Diaz Jr., who fights this weekend, May 6th, on the Canelo versus Chavez Jr. pay-per-view card. Jojo, man, big event, big main event. You're going to be on this card as well. How are you feeling so far this week?
Feeling good, man. I mean, it's already at the end of the week. The press conference went well. Now it's just waiting for the weigh-ins, weighing in, and then just rehydrating and getting ready for the fight. But overall, I had a great training camp, 10-week preparation, and I just can't wait to go out there and perform.
I'm glad you brought up the weight cut thing, because I've always been interested in talking to people about weight cutting, because when I wrestled, I had a certain way of cutting weight. You could say it wasn't the best way of cutting weight, because I'd cut like 7-8 pounds the night of.
Yeah,
but I guess, how do you approach the weight cutting, and how much weight are you cutting the night before?
Actually, this fight, I trained very hard, man, and I had the right nutrition, and I took care of business as far as making sure that I was at weight a week before my fight. I was only 4 pounds overweight a week before my fight. Today, I'm only 2 pounds. I'm like 128, 127, so I'm already right there, man. I trained very hard for this fight. Usually before, I lose about 4 or 5 pounds, 6 pounds the day before the weigh-ins, but my body just kind of feels fatigued and tired, but this time around, I know that I had a tough opponent ahead of me, so I had to take it very seriously, and I trained a lot better. My weight loss is better than ever.
You mentioned the before losing the weight, now that it's much better, but before, I guess, would you stop eating or drinking water like at 7 or 8 and then wake up a few pounds less, or how would that work?
Well, actually, I would hydrate all the way till Thursday night when I had to lose the weight. Yeah, so I would be 6 pounds, but it was just all water weight. Yeah, just all water weight. But I hate being in the sauna, man.
Dude, because it's the worst, bro. Yeah, it's the worst.
Sucks. And especially the time goes by so
slow. Do you go in the sauna with the bike, or you just kind of lay there?
No, I kind of run for like 5 minutes, get my body warm, and then I go in the sauna. But just the time goes by so slow in there, and then you have to lose 4 or 5 pounds. It's like,
and here's horrible. The worst thing. You're just thinking. You're sitting there, and you're just with your thoughts. And sometimes you just go nuts. Like, you just want to get the hell out of there.
Exactly. And that's how I always am. I'm constantly thinking inside the sauna. I'm like, okay, I'm just going to count a minute out loud, make sure hopefully it goes by faster. But it doesn't, man. So that's why this time around, I made sure that I'm at weight a lot lighter this time, so I don't have to hit the sauna. All I have to do is maybe run for 20 minutes, and I'll be at weight. I'll be probably 27, but I'll sleep it off because weigh-ins are at 230. Yeah. So I'll be at 27 tonight, but I'll sleep it off, and I'll be 126 tomorrow.
So tomorrow you'll go and you'll have a breakfast? Like, how do you approach that part? Because that to me is so interesting, because when I would weigh in, I'd wake up and I knew if I stopped eating like at 7, get a good night of rest, I'd probably cut about 3 pounds in my sleep, and then I'd wake up and I knew I was around weight. Yeah. And I wouldn't eat anything, just to make sure, not to be paranoid. I'd probably chew on ice and maybe like sip on ice a little bit, but I would never really eat anything. But our weigh-ins were like at noon or like at 11. You guys are in the afternoon, like at 3. So how do you approach the food part leading up to the weigh-in that day of the fight?
Because today I'm
gonna, the day of the win.
Yeah, the day of the wins, yeah. Because today I'm gonna have my oatmeal and I'm gonna eat still because I haven't ate. I'm gonna eat all my food, make sure that I'm energized for my workout tonight. And then if I'm at weight in the morning, because I know the weigh-ins are gonna be like around 2:30. So if I'm already underway, if I'm like 25 or 25.5, then I am gonna have something light just to make sure that I'm gonna be like 126 on the nose, because I don't wanna be super light in there. Go wake up, be 125, and then the time wanes, I'm gonna be 24. I'm like, what the heck, man? I suffered all that reason for nothing. Yeah, exactly. So I'm gonna go check my weight right in the morning. If I'm underweight, I'm probably gonna have some oatmeal or maybe an apple and some water just to stay energized.
I'm laughing because I remember when I wrestled, people would sometimes, they'd weigh in and they'd be like, fuck, I missed weight. And they're like, wait, I got to take a dump. Hold up, I'll be right back. And they go and they weigh like a pound less. That ever happened to you?
Nah, man, it don't happen to me. But it's kind of hard for me to go to the restroom and stuff during the week of the win, man, because I'm eating less, but I'm drinking a lot of proteins and taking a lot of fluids for I could be hydrated still. So I usually can't go to the restroom like during the week. But once I'm done the hydrated and I'm eating, then I'm able to go out there and enjoy my time, dude.
You know, you're in such a stacked division right now, Joseph. You got guys like Leo Santa Cruz, Abner Mares, Gary Russell Jr. I can go on and on and on and on. And you're on the rise right now.
Yeah.
So with that picture, how do you want to like put yourself in with, I know you want to go against all of them, but like, who is the one that most interests you at the core as a fighter? Like, you know what, I want to test my skills. I want to see how good I really am against this guy.
You know what, I want to, because I'm ranked number 2 in the WBC, and I'm ranked number 1 in the WBO. So after this fight, if everything goes well, the two champions that are in the WBC and WBO is Oscar Valdez and Gary Russell Jr. And I'm already right there to become mandatory. So after this fight, when I come out victorious, if everything goes well, and I come out victorious, hopefully I'm the mandatory for either the WBC or the WBO, and I'll be willing to fight either Gary Russell or Oscar Valdez for my next fight. These guys are very tough fighters, Oscar Valdez and Gary Russell, but at the end of the day, there's always tough fighters at 126 pounds. All of them are all tough, so there's not going to be no easy fight at 126 pounds to get a bout. So I'm willing to fight either Oscar Valdez, Gary Russell next, if that becomes mandatory.
To you, out of those two, who do you like more? Now, I want to say you'd probably like Oscar more because I think it would sell more, but Russell's a good choice too. But I guess out of the two, if you had a preference, who would you go with?
Out of the two, if I had the preference, I would go with Oscar Valdez. Yeah, reason is because we could sell out an arena in LA. It'll be a good fight for the Mexican-American fans and American fans as well, and Mexican fans. So it would just be a good turnout, man, and especially because we're both Olympians, former Olympians. We're both young, undefeated fighters as well coming up. It'll just be a great war for the fight fans. So, I mean, if that fight ever happens, and hopefully it does, I just can't wait until that fight happens.
That'd be a good fight, but I also like that fight with Gary Russell Jr. as well. I would pay to watch that fight. That'd be a really good fight. JoJo, as always, man, thank you so much. I really appreciate this man right here. Saturday night, fighting on this Canelo versus Chavez Jr. pay-per-view.